Joining us today for his take on the market, Japhet Tantianko, PhilStocks Financial. Japhet, good morning and good to have you.
Good morning, Ma'am Rain. Thank you very much for inviting me on your show.
Are there certain catalysts that you're looking at, watching for this week for direction? And does it include the supposed signing of the 2022 national budget this week? And what about the fourth Omicron case and perhaps slightly rising number of local COVID cases? Is that a concern for investors right now?
With respect to the market, yes, those are the factors that we are seeing right now, or those are the factors that we are monitoring right now. It's already the last trading week of the year, and initially we were expecting for a we were seeing an upward bias, and this is because of hopes coming from the Christmas spirit. We were expecting for hopes with respect to, you know, hopes for 2022, for a stronger 2022 economic prospect to bolster market sentiment for the last trading week of the year. Unfortunately, we have these new developments right now. So first and foremost, you have the discovery of the or the detection of the fourth Omicron case here in the Philippines. And then we are experiencing this uptick in cases, primarily in the National Capital Region. And finally, today, the supposed signing of the 2022 national budget was postponed. And these are things that are currently, we see that these things are currently weighing on sentiment because, as mentioned a while ago, we were hoping for a stronger 2022 in terms of economy. In terms of economic performance. But these factors that we are seeing right now, this could weigh on the bright economic prospects that we were that has been aforementioned.
Right. But if investors had already positioned ahead of an expected rally in the first quarter of next year, where are they placed right now? Which stocks or sectors?
Well, with respect to if you're going to look at stocks right now, I believe that there's been a repositioning with respect to the index members. So given that when the economy is expected to perform well in the near future, then that is the time that investors are placing their funds back into the index stocks, primarily the ones which are which are more risky. Because when the economy rallies or when the economy goes full swing, it's the risky stocks that tends to overperform, primarily the property and the banking stocks. So I believe this is where investors are placing their funds right now. So it's more of a rebalancing of portfolios, shifting from the risk-averse stocks, going towards the more risky ones within the index composition.
Sorry, can you repeat that? That means that fund managers are actually repositioning this week?
Well, that's what we are seeing with respect given the expectation of the of a good economic performance for next year.
Mm-hmm. Now, where do you see support and resistance in the immediate term if you're saying that they're rebalancing their portfolios based on the performance of the index?
Well, with respect to the market, the immediate support that we see right now is still the 7,000 to 7,100 range. Mm-hmm. As for the resistance, we see it at 7,300. Now, if ever the 7,300 resistance gets breached, the next resistance is at 7,500.
Mm-hmm. There's the IPO announcement of Balayini Frutas for March next year, as well as CTS Global Equity Group. What are the prospects for these planned IPOs? How will investors react to these disclosures?
Well, with respect to the IPOs that has just been disclosed, we have yet to assess them. We are still going to look into them. But the applications for IPOs, the mounting application for IPOs, it shows investors' confidence. It shows that many businesses are already anticipating that there's going to be a that the economic recovery is going to continue this 2022, that the economic recovery momentum is going to strengthen, and that the economy is really moving towards its next expansion phase. And with this anticipation, businesses are already now planning, plotting their capital raising activities in order to prepare for such expansion. And that's the reason that we are seeing of why we have many IPO applications right now.
House stock IPO priced at 1 peso and 50 centavos per share. What's your assessment on this pricing versus valuation among other matrices?
Well, with respect to house stock, based on our assessment so far, our projected PE ratio for the stock is at 50 times. And this is quite overvalued with respect to its peers. Most of the property sectors who are heavy on residentials have a PE ratio of less than 10. So PE ratio-wise or marketability-wise, the stock is quite overvalued. We saw that in 2018, it has a high net income, which unfortunately plunged in 2019. And we are seeing recovery this 2020 and 2021, but it's not yet reaching the 2018 levels. So there's still a lot with respect to prospects, as mentioned a while ago, given the recovery of the economy, the property sector is one of those sectors which tends to overperform. So industry wise, it's good. But then again, you have tight competition. And at the same time, given that overvaluation in terms of the marketability ratio. So there's for now, we see a lot of risks for this IPO.
Lots of risks. Okay. Well, finally, this Philex mining labor strike happening just as it announced its plan for a $224 million copper and gold mining project in Surigao del Norte, which was hit hard by Typhoon Odette. It will be ready for commercial use supposedly by late 2024 or early 2025. Do you see this as potentially affecting investor sentiment for the stock?
Well, yes, with respect to the labor strike, it may have a negative impact on Philex, because if you're going to have a labor strike, then it somehow paralyzes the operations of the company. So what we're hoping for is that this deadlock between the management and the labor would be immediately resolved. And once it gets immediately resolved, then the company can resume normal operations, so that they can achieve, you know, they can achieve the financial performances that they are targeting.
Finally, what are investors looking forward to in the first quarter of 2022?
Well, for the first quarter of 2022, there's a lot that investors are really looking into, or a lot that investors can digest. First and foremost, it is in the first quarter 2022 when we get to see a full picture of how 2021 performed, because this is going to be the time when we're going to see the fourth quarter and full year GDP performance, as well as some of the full year and fourth quarter company financial results. So this is one of the things that that investors will be watching out for. As mentioned a while ago, we have a support at 7,000 to 7,100 and a resistance at 7,300. Now, if we get to see good results, a robust economic and robust economic and company results for the fourth quarter and for the full year 2021, then there's this possibility that the market could breach that 7,300 resistance level. Unfortunately, there are also risks that we have to watch out for. As mentioned, we still have lingering uncertainties caused by the Omicron variant. Now, if this Omicron variant does worsen, if we see a resurgence of cases here in the Philippines, that's going to be a risk to the downside. It could lead to the market retesting the 7,000 to 7,100 support range. Another thing that investors will be watching out for, or will be monitoring still, is the 2022 national budget. If this gets signed on time, then it will add boost to the market, and it will help us, you know, it will give a boost to sentiment in the first quarter 2022. Unfortunately, if it doesn't get signed on time, then it's also another downside risk. And then finally, with respect to offshore, investors will be watching out for the Federal Reserve, how their monetary steps or monetary plans are going to be. if their monetary tightening will come sooner than later, then it's going to be another downside risk for the market. So we're really, for 2022 in the first quarter, breaching that 7,300 resistance and reaching 7,500. We're pinning our hopes on the good fourth quarter and full year 2021 economic and company results, as well as a continuation of those. But as mentioned, there are risks from COVID-19, from the Omicron variant to the possible delay in the signing of the 2022 national budget, and finally the monetary steps from the Federal Reserve.
Well, lots of good reminders there, and grateful as always for your assessment, Japheth Antianko, PhilStocks Financial. Thank you so much for joining us today. We appreciate the market guidance. Thank you.
You're very much welcome.